What is never fun for an INFJ? INFJs are often called the rarest personality type in the Myers-Briggs system, known for their deep empathy, intuitive nature, and passion for meaning and connection. But despite their many strengths, INFJs face unique challenges that can make certain experiences feel anything but fun. In this video, we'll explore what is never fun for an INFJ, diving into 12 scenarios that feel especially draining or challenging for this unique personality type. Stick around to the end to better understand the hidden struggles of INFJs and how they turn those struggles into strengths. 1. Crowded spaces and overstimulation. INFJs thrive in calm, meaningful environments. Crowded spaces, with their noise, energy, and lack of personal space, can feel overwhelming. The sheer volume of sensory input can overstimulate their sensitive nature, leaving them feeling drained. An INFJ attending a crowded music festival might feel anxious despite enjoying the music. The constant flow of people, loud sounds, and lack of quiet space can make them crave solitude. Their introverted nature means they recharge in quiet, reflective environments. Crowds disrupt this balance, making it hard for them to feel at ease. 2. Being too sensitive. The INFJ's heightened sensitivity to emotions can be a double-edged sword. While it allows them to connect deeply with others, it also means they're easily affected by negative emotions or harsh criticism. A simple offhand remark from a friend might linger in an INFJ's mind for days, as they replay the conversation and analyze its deeper meaning. This sensitivity can lead to emotional exhaustion and self-doubt, especially when INFJs feel misunderstood or unfairly judged. 1. Trying to fit in. INFJs often feel like outsiders, even in familiar social circles. Their unique worldview and deep thinking nature can make it difficult for them to fit into surface-level conversations or social norms. At a casual work party, an INFJ might struggle to engage in small talk, feeling disconnected from the shallow interactions around them. Pretending to fit in feels inauthentic, which goes against the INFJ's core values of authenticity and integrity. 4. Ending a relationship or friendship. For INFJs, relationships are sacred. When they form a connection, it's often deep and meaningful. Ending a relationship, whether romantic or platonic, feels like a profound loss. An INFJ ending a friendship might spend months agonizing over the decision, reflecting on every moment that led to the fallout. The emotional toll of letting go is immense. INFJs often blame themselves or wonder if they could have done more to save the relationship. 5. Being cold to someone. Despite their empathetic nature, there are times when INFJs need to set boundaries and distance themselves from toxic people. However, being cold or distant doesn't come naturally to them and feels deeply uncomfortable. An INFJ cutting off a manipulative friend might struggle with guilt, even though they know it's the right decision. Their compassion makes it hard to detach emotionally, even when the situation demands it. 6. Spotting a lie. INFJs have a natural ability to sense when someone is being dishonest. While this can be a useful skill, it also comes with its downsides. Discovering a lie, especially from someone they trust, feels like a betrayal. An INFJ catching a friend in a lie might feel deeply hurt and question the entire relationship. Their trust is a hard one, and losing it can be heartbreaking. 7. Loving someone too much. INFJs love deeply and intensely, often putting their partner's needs above their own. While this can create beautiful, soulful connections, it also leaves them vulnerable to heartbreak. An INFJ in a one-sided relationship might continue giving their all, hoping things will change, even as they feel drained and unappreciated. The emotional toll of unreciprocated love can lead to burnout and self-neglect. 8. Struggling to express themselves. Despite their deep thoughts and emotions, INFJs often struggle to articulate what they're feeling. This can lead to frustration and a sense of isolation. An INFJ trying to explain their feelings to a friend might find themselves tongue-tied, unable to convey the depth of their emotions. The inability to express themselves fully can make them feel misunderstood and alone. 9. Needing alone time misunderstood as distance. INFJs need regular alone time to recharge, but this can be misinterpreted by friends and family as being distant or aloof. An INFJ declining a social invitation might face questions like, "Are you mad at me?" or "Why are you being so distant?" Constantly explaining their need for solitude can be exhausting and make them feel guilty for prioritizing their mental health. 10. Emotional detachment. INFJs value emotional connections, but there are times when they need to detach for self-preservation. This detachment can feel unnatural and painful. An INFJ distancing themselves from a toxic relationship might feel numb and disconnected, even as they know it's necessary. The loss of emotional connection feels like losing a part of themselves. While INFJs face unique challenges, their struggles are also what make them extraordinary. Their deep empathy, passion for authenticity, and commitment to meaningful connections set them apart. By embracing their true selves and learning to navigate these difficult experiences, INFJs can turn their struggles into strengths. If you're an INFJ or know someone who is, remember that your sensitivity and depth are your greatest gifts. Embrace who you are, set boundaries when needed, and continue to seek out the connections and experiences that nourish your soul. Let us know in the comments which INFJ struggles you resonate with the most. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more insights into the world of personality types. Stay safe, and see you in the next one.